Media and Information Literacy, the heart and soul of the digital world. It focuses on being a good and responsible netizen, knowing the rules and regulations when using the internet and giving the mass media timely and relevant information over the cyberspace. People had been using this technology for many years now, but only few people know how to use it properly. Different kinds of hackers and spammers are spawning in the internet. This subject also teaches you on how to safely use the internet and helps you avoid these illegal beings inside the internet.
Empowerment of people through information and media literacy is an important prerequisite for fostering equitable access to information and knowledge and building inclusive knowledge societies. Media literacy is a 21st century approach to education. It provides a framework to access, analyze, evaluate, create, and participate with messages in variety of forms, from print to video to the internet. Media literacy builds an understanding of role of media in society, as well as essential skills of inquiry and self-expression necessary for citizens of a democracy. Media and information literacy is a recently developed pedagogical approach that takes into consideration the new cultures emerging from the information society.
Sa ngayon, isa akong radio laboratory dito sa Duke University, which means na ako yung mga nag-guide or tumutulong dun sa mga estudyante, most especially dun sa broadcasting or any communication na parang connected ng mga students na gagamit.
Sa publication po namin, ang line of work po is writer, pero usually nag-take part ako as layout or graphic design.
Of course, syempre, hindi naman ako papasok dito kung hindi ako mag-join. And besides, ito kasi yung pinili kong line since I was an audiovisual communication student. Takan saan, pinapractice din namin yung pag-broadcast. Which is, tapos pinili ko kasi talaga na mapasok sa
industry. I do enjoy writing because that's why I chose this course, journalism.
If I am not mistaken, traditional media is journalism that does not involve technology. The new media is the media that we use today, which involves technology and use of the internet, such as social media and the media that is propagated with the internet.
Para sa akin kasi, yung traditional media, dyan tayo nagsimula. So kung sabihin natin na parang numero lang yan, kung hindi tayo nagsimula sa 1, hindi tayo pupunta dun sa 100.
No, I do not believe that we should do that because if we are to look to traditional media to be a form of media that is trusted, we can further inculcate the idea to the masses that these two forms of media can work hand in hand because traditional media is the root of the media that we have today.
My professor once said na ang traditional media like print news or television or radio, sabi niya daw, hindi mawawala, pero unlikely, hindi ka mawawala pa rin yun. Kasi, honestly, mababating niya na online media and no one really do you read the news? In newsprint news, maybe you don't. If you don't, usually you don't. Kasi, mga pa-old people like. Pero I don't think it's obsolete. I think, obsolete in the future.
Yun na nga, nasabi ko, diba, yung radio, yung radyo ngayon. So, yun yung mga traditional media na tinatawag natin. Pero nga, siya, tulad ng dyaryo ngayon, nakikita na natin siya nasa internet na, diba? Yung ibang mga, hindi na ako magpapangalan ng ibang mga dyaryo na ginagamit na ngayon sa internet na doon na kinukuha yung mga information. Pero para sa akin, ano pa rin yung
journalism today may be an example that has transcended into modernity because we see that students in schools and certain reporters may post it on the internet so that they may be able to reach more.
Yung traditional sa Philippines, admin Manila Times, ngayon meron pa rin, rapper actually dati, wala hindi, rapper, online na yun. Philippine Daily Inquirer, Manila Bulletin. Yung Manila Bulletin and Philippine Daily Inquirer, nagka-transcend niya siya itong modernity. kasi ang ginagawa niya, may mga online na siya sites, may sariling website, may social Facebook page, may mga iba nga na may yung grad magazine, may Instagram na magazine.
Of course, kasi kahit pa paano, nagagamit pa rin siya. Hindi kasi lahat nakaka-access dun sa modern, na tinatawag natin mga modern media like blogs or virtual newspapers. Kasi may mga tao pa rin na mas nagre-relate. Tsaka mas madali kasing ma-access yung traditional media compared sa modern media. Pero hindi ko naman sinasabi na hindi maganda yung modern media. Para sa akin, hindi dapat kinoconsider na luma yung traditional media. Dahil kahit balik-balik pa rin tayo natin, nagagamit at may pa rin siya sa kasalukuyan. Parang may silbi pa rin siya sa
kasalukuyan. I am not willing to revert back to traditional media because we have already social societal evolution that has accepted new media.